Now, you have here the ritual for the burnt sacrifice. Let's notice this. Verse 5, and he shall kill the bullock before the Lord and the priests. Aaron's son shall bring the blood and sprinkle the blood round about upon the altar that's by the door of the tabernacle of the congregation. Now, this is the ritual. A proper offering having been chosen, that is the right kind of animal, the sinner brings the victim to the entrance of the tabernacle where he's met by the priests. And the sinner himself slays the victim. And the wages of sin's death. And here the innocent's dying for the guilty. And Christ suffered the just for the unjust. Our sins put him to death. If you want it made very personal, my sin is responsible for the death of Christ. I get a little weary today of hearing people try to argue who's responsible for the death of Christ. And they'll pick out, they say, the religious rulers, the nation Israel, the Roman nation. My friend, you can argue that all you want to, but if I hadn't been a sinner and if you hadn't been a sinner, nobody would put him to death. It's our sin that put him to death. Now, verses 6 through 9, and I'll just read this. This is so important. And he shall slay the burnt offering, cut it into pieces, and the sons of Aaron, the priests, shall put fire upon the altar, lay the wood in order upon the fire and the priests. And you see, they cut it in pieces so that the fire would get to every part of it and consume it. And also, everything was put in order, if you'll notice here. Everything has to be done decently in order. God is not the author of confusion. Now, Aaron's son shall lay the parts, the head and the fat, in order upon the wood that's on the fire, which is upon the altar. But his inwards and his legs shall he wash in water, and the priest shall burn all on the altar to be a burnt sacrifice, an offering made by fire of a sweet savor unto the Lord. And you see, by it being cut in pieces and everything exposed, it's the inner life of the Lord Jesus has been opened for inspection for over 1,900 years. I do not suppose any person has ever been examined more than he has. And there's still a lot of disagreement concerning him. He still asks the question, whom do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And there's all kinds of opinions today, and some of them are blasphemy. But it's still true, he's holy, harmless, undefiled, and separate from sinners. Now, notice here, we're told that he shall put fire upon the altar. And then when you read down in this section here, verse 10, and if his offering be of the flocks, namely the sheep or the goats for a burnt sacrifice, he shall bring it a male without blemish. He shall kill it on the side of the altar northward before the Lord, and the priest Aaron's son shall sprinkle his blood round about upon the altar. He shall cut it in pieces with his head and fat. The priest shall lay them in order on the wood that is on the fire which is upon the altar, but he shall wash the inwards and the legs with water, and the priest shall bring it all and burn it upon the altar. It's a burnt sacrifice, an offering made by fire of a sweet savor unto the Lord. Now, I've read all of this in order that we might see these details here, that he is the one who's been examined all these years, and he's still the one that's altogether lovely. And the fire here does not necessarily represent hell. I disagree with these who magnify that so much. It doesn't represent vengeance or wrath either. It did not at the burning bush. There, fire represented, I think, oftentimes the purifying energy and resistless power of God. The Scripture says he's a refiner and a purifier of silver. Takes fire to do that. Fire is that resistless energy of God that sometimes destroys, but sometimes cleanses, and sometimes consumes. And the nature of the object determines the process. In the burnt offering, it speaks of the total commitment of Christ to God. It's absolute consecration. In our experience, this is essential also if we're to worship God in spirit and in truth. In Deuteronomy, we're told, Deuteronomy 4:24, For the Lord thy God is a consuming fire, even a jealous God. My friend, you're not going to play around and get very far with God. That's the reason that there's so much that's phony today in our churches. And there's so much that's phony today in Christian service. My friend, I want to say it kindly, but I want to say it, you're not serving God unless you're letting Him cleanse and purify your life. We've forgotten this matter of holiness today, and we need a little bit more of it in our churches.